we started with the idea of learning from our ancestors and getting as many of these products back into our households as possible. And that's the genesis of this business. And what we have done is, okay, we work with a number of rural artisans across Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Orissa, West Bengal, Manipur, Kerala also, in terms of identifying those traditional clusters who have been making a lot of these products, which have been part of our grandmother's household, and we're bringing it back. And that's one of the key ideas that we're focusing on.
So we have about 80 products currently. What we are trying to do is we are trying to reach as many people as possible in terms of, we are on various e-commerce platforms, but we are also building our own e-commerce platform currently. We also have a display center in Jayanagar, so people can come and have a conversation with us and probably learn more about what they want to buy and how to use these products at home.
From a business sense today, what we see is that people do understand that there is a value to go back into the traditional way of living. There is a great awareness and understanding in terms of wanting to do away with some of the harmful chemicals in their day-to-day life, be it plastics or be it Teflon. Or there is an awareness which is being created in India and globally as well, that you want to move away from these harmful chemicals, how it impacts you, your system, your body, your family. Number two is how it also impacts your impacts Earth in terms of sustainability, you know.
In addition to it, one of the key aspects that we focus on is in terms of how do we build a very sustainable household. And what we're looking at is products, those are not about art, not about craft, is about how do we transform your household to a more sustainable place. And that's the key objective that we keep in our mind when we go after artisan clusters and even the products that we bring
in. In terms of challenges, one, most of these artisan clusters are very, very primitive. And they don't understand the concept of commerce or business or anything of that sort. So you work in terms of, you know, meeting the demand as well as in terms of the supply chain, because they have absolutely no clue as to how they're going to ship the product from a particular place to the other, considering most of the products are fragile. So it's a major challenge in terms of building the supply chain, and also in terms of, say, for people to understand what all of these can, how it can be used at home, and how a lot of them don't understand the concept of sustainability. So, and there's always a doubt as to how it can be used. Can I genuinely change from a non-stick to iron? Is it a lot more time consuming? Is it? So these are challenges that you primarily face.
This is Tamil language is called EHM. This is actually a tin whistle. The one that intrigues people the most. Every event we go, every customer who comes to our place and talks about it, first wants to know what this is. And you know, we keep joking saying it's tin, then you know, you ask again, then it's like tin, so you have to explain what tin is. This is a metal, it's used predominantly for making a South Indian delicacy called rasam. Most of us, in fact all the three of us, have grown up in our houses, and even today we make rasam in this. It gives a unique flavor and an aroma to the rasam. That's extremely important if you are a rasam lover. And second thing is the tamarind in the tamarind actually reacts with the tin here, and it gives that flavor, additional flavor to it. Tin is also known for several healing properties from your cold, cough, and it's got its own properties where it's used. We also got educated recently that consuming rasam in this one, in fact, improves your blood flow. So there probably our ancestors knew that there were health benefits. Though we all finally at some point we realize that there is a taste benefit and an aroma out of it, and we love that. So it has both a combination of health, aroma, flavor and taste to it.
This is another unique vessel, it's called soapstone. Predominantly available in Tamil Nadu, and to a certain extent they mined it in Karnataka also. But this particular type of stone is not as hard as granite, but not as soft as tile. It has got the right kind of density for cooking. Very earthy substance, and anything with tamarind tastes amazingly well. But it has a very high heat carrying capacity. So once you cook food in this, it is kept warm for almost like 5 to 6 hours. So it's almost like a hard case, which you don't have to reheat food.